Chairman Goldstein and members of the commission. My name is Lenora Fulani, and though this commission is newly appointed, I've spoken before prior commissions about the structure and design of New York City's political process. In 2003, I advocated strongly, together with Mayor Bloomberg, for a shift to nonpartisan elections. At the time, there was a general outcry that the commission was moving too fast to consider such a significant restructuring. And we've begun to hear that refrain again from some political partisans who no doubt intend to oppose nonpartisan reform as they did in 2003. That's their right, nobody questions that. But speaking now as an independent and as a leader of the Independence Party, New York City's nonpartisan political party, the serious question is not whether we are moving slowly enough, it's whether we're moving quickly enough. Quickly enough to keep up with our young people who don't identify with parties and don't like partisanship. If we don't move quickly, we will pay a price. The results of the 2003 elections on nonpartisans are well known. The measure failed 70% to 30%. This has become a talking point for opponents, a rallying cry. The voters have spoken, they say, case closed. But we can never close the case on democracy after a single round. If we had, black people would still be 3/5 of a person, and women would not have won the right to vote. Since the commission last addressed nonpartisan elections in 2003, a lot has changed in New York City and in the country. Enthusiasm for the establishment parties is declining, while enthusiasm for political independence as the antidote to partisan gridlock and dysfunction is growing all over the place. The votes cast on the major party lines in the last citywide election either declined in the case of the Republican Party or flatlined in the case of the Democratic Party. But the trend is in the other direction when it comes to independents. The 150,000 votes cast on the independents line in the last election was double what it was in 2005 and three times that of 2001. This all comes down to a very simple question of democracy. There are currently, and I have to pick this up because I can't see it, 897,180 registered voters in New York City who are neither Democrats or Republicans. The vast majority, 751,442 of them, are not aligned with any political party. Among these non-aligned voters, 25% of them are under the age of 30, 20% are African American, 24% Latino, and 11% are Asian American. As the city has become majority-minority, it's the case that the minority community is increasingly independent. We need to change our electoral system to include and empower them. In closing, I want to ask the commission to listen to those new and independent voices. I ask you to acknowledge the 18-year-old black youth in Harlem who registered independent but cannot vote in the decision-making round of most elections, the Latino mom in the Bronx whose kids are in public school but whose vote does not count in September, the Chinese student in Queens whose family came here to find democracy only to be turned away from the polls on primary day because he is registered as an independent. I urge the commission to listen to these voices. I urge the commission to recognize the need for change. I urge the commission to bring nonpartisan elections forth to the ballot. Thank you.
Our next speaker is Harvey Kresge.